Hey YouTube, what's going on? It's Angelo back again with another episode of Past Manelli's Point. But before we get actually into this video, what I want to say is like, comment, and subscribe. And I can't stress that enough. Comment and subscribe because I want to know what you guys have to say. Also, please hit that notification bell so you don't ever miss a video. One other thing I want to tell you is thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the love and support that you guys are giving me. I just reached 60 subscribers over the weekend. It's not a huge number, but to me, I really do pay attention to that stuff, and I really appreciate everybody following me and watching my videos. It means a lot. This is something I've been wanting to do for a while, and you know, I finally got the courage to actually get up, you know, sit down and do it. And I really do enjoy making these videos for you, so you guys keep watching, and I'll keep making. Other than those little things, let's get to the point. So, first off, what I'd like to say is I do have a recommendation for you guys if you guys are looking for something to watch and maybe you haven't seen it. Castle Rock. It's a show on Hulu. Really, really enjoy it. I want to say Alexander Skarsgård. It's one of the Skarsgårds.
What?
It's the same Skarsgård who played It. He is in the first season. He's very creepy. Definitely makes you uneasy while you're watching him. It's basically about a town that's kind of cursed. It's all Stephen King related. You know, there's Stephen King characters and places and things like that. But the second season has Lizzie Caplan in there, and she's amazing. Amazing part she plays.
They can use you and own you and throw you away, but I won't let them. It'll be blood on Christmas before I let them join. I'll throw my blame box.
But the reason I bring up Lizzie Caplan specifically is I've always had a crush on Lizzie Caplan, so for me to see her on screen doing something else, I do really enjoy watching her act. I think she's a good actress, but also the first show I've ever seen her in was Party Down. If you guys never seen Party Down, Adam Scott's in it, and so is she, and there's another like three or four ensemble cast guys who are very funny. Party Down's about a bunch of servers, you know, doing their day-to-day job. One guy used to be like a famous child actor, but
who's fucking talking?
What?
You're not even an actor. You're a haircut.
What does that okay? even mean?
Check it out. It is hilarious. I believe that is also on Hulu right now. So either one of those shows, if you get a chance, check them out. The next thing I'd like to talk about is they just finalized a deal with Christian Bale to play the villain in Thor: Love and Thunder. I'm very, very, very excited to see Christian Bale as the villain in Thor. Like, you get Batman from DC coming to Marvel to be a bad guy. And I've heard different things. I heard he could possibly be Gore the God Butcher. I heard he could possibly be Adam Warlock. I'm really leaning more towards Adam Warlock, hopefully. But it doesn't matter. I'm excited to see him in the movie. The next thing I want to talk about is the new Black Widow trailer dropped. It should be the final trailer before the movie's released, and it looks amazing. I don't know if I am the only person who's super, super excited to see the movie. Maybe it's because I love Scarlett Johansson. I think she's a great actress. She's a great fit as Black Widow. But I really am interested more in to see what happens with Taskmaster. From what I see, I saw something on Instagram today. I'm going to put that up for you guys right now. I think that Taskmaster's been studying the Avengers, and he knows all their moves, which is going to make it very, very hard for Black Widow and Red Guardian and the rest of the group that is trying to defeat Taskmaster to actually beat him. So I'm really excited to see that. Also, I would like to talk about a show called Lock and Key, and the reason I'm bringing this up, that is the next show that I want to watch after Castle Rock, but I actually really want to know what everybody else has to say out there. Let me know if you've seen it. I'm very interested in watching it. I had someone today at work tell me it was very good, but I want to know what the YouTube community has to say about it. So please comment down below and let me know what you guys think. Now let's get into the meat of the show. The reason we're here, the top five movie badasses. So basically the way I went about this is there's no superheroes on this list. So Sorry, guys, like, you know, Wolverine and Captain America and even Batman. You're not on the list. Number two, you can't be only in one movie. It has to be multiple. It doesn't have to be a franchise, per se. It could just be a movie and then a sequel. But I wanted to make sure that I went that way as well. And again, like I said, these are my personal picks. Nothing is, you know, like concrete. You know, I'm sure people have other picks. So listen to the list and tell me if I left somebody out. So we're going to start with number one. The number one badass, John McClane. John McClane from Die Hard. He's been in five movies. He's been in Die Hard, Die Hard 2, Die Hard with a Vengeance, Live Free or Die Hard, and A Good Day to Die Hard. So not all the movies are great, but to me, the first Die Hard is, it's so classic. I mean, for me, every Christmas, and I don't care what anybody says, you can debate me on this all day, every day, I don't care. You'll never get me to change my mind. I don't care if Bruce Willis himself comes up to me and tells me, hey, you idiot, this isn't a Christmas movie. I don't care. To me, it's a Christmas movie. You know why? Because every Christmas Eve, I watch Die Hard. I start a Christmas Eve night. I get too tired. I fall asleep. Watch the rest of it in the morning. Then we open presents. It's like a little tradition I have. So I'm going to do it regardless. But Die Hard has this great scenes and different things, but the best part about it is he's not a 6'5", 450-pound guy cracking skulls. It's John McClane, a New York City cop in LA, just a regular blue-collar guy, and he saves a bunch of people's lives. There's all kind of cool stuff in the movie. Different shootouts, different jokes. That's another reason I really like John McClane, because he's a badass, but he's also joking around, making people laugh, you know, during the movie. But, you know, you got when he paints the guy's sweatshirt and says, now I have a machine gun, ho, 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 or...
Think you have a chance against us, Mr. Cowboy?
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
And when you hear that, you know that something is about to happen. Something's going to go down. Die Hard 2 is good. I think that's overlooked sometimes because it's in the airport. People forget about that. But when he blows up the plane, that was pretty sweet. Die Hard 3, which is Die Hard with a Vengeance with Sam Jackson, I really enjoyed also just because of the pure fact of Sam Jackson and Bruce Willis and their chemistry together. Live Free or Die Hard and Good Day to Die Hard, those are pretty rough watches. And even sometimes Die Hard with a Vengeance is rough to watch. But the best probably scene to me out of all of them is when he flies a car into a helicopter to take it down. I mean, that is the epitome of what a badass is. So, we'll go on to number two. Number two is John Wick. Now, how are you going to have a top five badass list and not put Keanu Reeves on there? I mean, I could have put John Wick. I could have put Neo from The Matrix. I even could have put his character from Speed, but he was only in one movie, so I had to nix that out. But anyways, John Wick, he was in John Wick 1, John Wick 2, John Wick 3, and I'm sure there's another John Wick coming out. I know there's talks of a Continental show. So, John Wick, the story to me is crazy. He's known as like the boogeyman, but he's retired, he's married, he wants to get out of it. His wife dies, she sends him a dog, and that's like the only piece of his wife he has left. And these guys come in and rob him, they kill his dog, they steal his car, yada, yada, yada. But the boogeyman is back.
People keep asking if I'm back, and I haven't really had an answer. But now, yeah, I'm thinking I'm back.
And I mean, is he back with a vengeance? He just beats the crap out of everybody he comes across. There is all kind of cool scenes in each movie. And the best part about it is Keanu Reeves actually did all this training himself. The gun training and stuff like that. Unbelievable. unbelievable what this guy did to actually embody John Wick. And John Wick's also so cool. You know, he's got his all-black suit with a black tie and his white shirt. And he gets beat up and it gets all tattered. But he never stops coming. He's going to come and get you. It doesn't matter. John Wick 1, excellent. Instant classic. John Wick 2, I thought was very good. And I like John Wick 3 maybe even the most. That scene on the horses where the motorcycle guys are chasing him and he's just beating the crap out of them on the horses. Or he has a scene like, I don't know if it's like a butcher shop or some kind of place like a knife museum. It is unbelievable. Unbelievable. And then they have, you know, Halle Berry's in the third one. I believe Common's in the second one. And Common and him have like a battle between each other that's really good. There's just... I could sit here and talk about... do a whole video on John Wick and tell you how many different scenes and how many cool things he does. But, I mean, John Wick, it's just like... every time they make a John Wick movie, they do something that surprises me. And I think that's what grabs my attention. It's not the same. It's not a movie with a sequel in a different place with the same moves. I mean, I like Taken, and I feel like Taken's kind of like same movie, Taken 1, and then Taken 2, someone else is Taken, but it's kind of the same. And Taken 3, someone else is Taken. It's, you know what I mean? So, like I said, John Wick's number 2. John Wick keeps going how it's going. I'm sure he'll bump John McClane from his first place spot, but as of right now, John Wick is my number 2. Number 3 is The Terminator. Now, I know it's kind of hard. So, The Terminator has been in Terminator, Terminator 2, Terminator 3, Terminator Genesis, and Terminator Dark Fate. I can tell you right now, Genesis and Dark Fate I have not seen, but I solely place him on this list just for Terminator 1 and Terminator 2. Now, Terminator 1, he was the bad guy, and Terminator 2, he was the good guy. He is the only person on this list that's been a bad guy and a good guy. Now, as a bad guy, he's, you know, he's pretty bad, and he loses and all that stuff, but who cares about that? Did he do some cool stuff? Sure. I'm here to talk about Terminator 2, though. Terminator 2... better than the original, I don't care what you have to say about it, because I truly believe Terminator 2 is one of those very few movies that's a sequel that's better than the original. I mean, you get Arnold the good guy, and he's got to take down this liquid metal, the T-1000, you know? It's some of the things he does, the shotgun in the rose, how he, you know, brings that out and shoots it.
Come with me if you want to live.
Gunfight with the helicopter, the semi-truck scene, that is unbelievable. That scene has me on the edge of my seat, and I think it's because you got the semi-truck, you got Arnold on the bike, the kid's life's in danger, and the musical score in that scene is just, that's what gets me on my edge. You know, it gets me right to the edge of my seat, and I don't know if he's going to survive. Purely based off of Terminator 2, I feel like he makes this list. But Terminator 3, Terminator, you know, he did some cool stuff. But Terminator 2 is like perfection when it comes to being a badass. Leather jacket, you know.
Hasta la vista, baby.
You know, stuff like that. That is where it's at, man. I really enjoy that movie. Number 4, if you don't see here, I got a Hail to the King shirt on, would be Ash Williams. Now, some of you people might have no idea who Ash Williams is. Ash Williams is in The Evil Dead. So you have Evil Dead 1, Evil Dead 2, Army of Darkness, and he's also in a TV show, Ash vs. the Evil Dead. And I know I said top 5 movie badasses, but he is an exception because he does cross over to TV. Same character, just on a TV show. Now, for those of you who don't know, the first Evil Dead is basically a horror movie made by Sam Raimi. It's a little different. Evil Dead 2 is almost like they reboot it, and it's kind of funny. But what happens is his arm gets infected, and he cuts his arm off, and he ends up putting a chainsaw onto his arm, and he's got a shotgun, and he calls it his boomstick. So he becomes this total badass character that You know, even though he was faced with adversity, with these deadites, as they call them, he still comes out on top. Now, Army of Darkness is where he really shows how much of a badass he really is. Because Evil Dead 2, he survives the cabin, he makes it out, and all of a sudden he falls through, like, this wormhole. And he goes to, like, the medieval times, and they see this guy with a chainsaw for an arm and this shotgun. But, I mean, he kills a witch.
Yo, she bitch. Let's go.
He does all kind of cool stuff. They fight these skeletons, and I mean, just the way he moves around. But the other thing about Ash Williams is he's just so cool. He's calm. He's collected. He's funny. He's also like a hot shot. And if you guys don't know Bruce Campbell, he's the actor who plays Ash Williams. I mean, to me, Bruce Campbell is probably one of the best like B movie actors. You know, he was in Bubba Hotep. He was in a bunch of different, you know, small things. But when they brought Ash vs. Evil Dead out to, I believe it was like Showtime or Cinemax or something like that, I was so pumped to see Bruce Campbell back as Ash Williams. And he still's got it, man. He's still such a badass, killing deadites, saving people, and nobody can touch his chainsaw and his boomstick. What a badass.
Hail to the king, baby.
And then number five, my last pick. Some people might find this a little unorthodox, but to me, I like The Bride from Kill Bill 1 and 2. I just think she's just unstoppable sometimes. When she fights the crazy 88, it's literally crazy how much blood is spilled. She fights, I can't remember Lucy Liu's character, but she fights her. She fights the girl with like the ball and chain, and she gets kind of beat up, but she beats her. There's just so many different fight scenes. You can't wait for her to kill Bill. You actually empathize with her character. Like, how could someone do this to her and leave her for dead? She deserves to get her revenge and her vengeance. And that is the best part about it, is that it's not sold short. You actually get to see it happen. She plucks out someone's eyeball. She goes through rough training. But man, does she know how to use a knife. Those are two of the best female-driven action movies that I feel like I've ever seen. I feel like it's hard not to put another person on this list, just because there's so many people that I came across as I was like doing research. I mean, John McClane and John Wick were an easy 1 and 2, but when I was scrolling through and looking at things and I saw The Bride, I knew I had to put her on here. She's just so pissed off, angry. And that is a little bit of all of us sometimes. We wish we can get revenge on people who've wronged us, but she actually does it, and you can kind of live through her. But there's so many great villains that she faces and fights, and that's kind of the best part of the movie. Is like, it's almost like a video game. She goes through like these little parts, and then she faces like a boss. When she gets stuck inside that coffin and she gets herself out, oh my God. That's like the one-inch punch kind of from Bruce Lee. Excellent. I thought it was amazing. I couldn't believe how cool that was and how she dug herself out of the dirt from almost dead. So, that is my top five list. Please, like I said at the beginning, if you have anything that you think I missed, anybody that I didn't put on this list, please put it down below. Drop a comment, man. I want to hear it. Maybe I did miss somebody. Maybe I can do a revised list, you know, something like that later on in the future. But video's over, folks.
What? No.
But we'll see you again soon. Thanks for watching. Thanks for the support. Appreciate it.